Hey y'all, welcome to my channel. Everybody says that on YouTube, so I figured that I had to say it too, but welcome. Okay, so to start off with, actually this is a coloring video because I didn't really think that I should draw right away. Don't ask me why, I'm weird. But anyway, I wanted to just quickly show you all kind of my art style, what you're going to get with this channel, because, you know, some art styles are just unbearable for people, and if mine's unbearable, you don't have to tell me, but, yeah, I mean, you don't have to stay. So anyway, one of my characters, chibi form, of course. Another character, I love to use washi tape. I'm going to be using washi tape a lot. This one, not too happy about the sky, but it was just a little something that I did because I got new rainbow tape and I wanted to do something with it. I do a lot of creatures, I guess we could say. I do a lot of girls. I'm not very good at doing guys, but I am practicing. Here's a couple. These are also my characters. So about this one, I was sad that I saw all these videos about drawing prompts, and I've never participated in Inktober or what's the other one, the Mermaid Month or anything. I really want to do one this year, but I was looking up drawing prompts because I didn't know what to draw. And my husband found one, and he's like, letters. So, like, okay. So I drew one of my characters getting a million love letters from her crush. This one is not really a style I do much because I like kind of like that outline, usually black outline, but this was just kind of an experiment. I only use washi tape on her legs, but I found that the Copics that I had really matched the washi tape, and I really wanted to do something funny about it. Washi tape. You guys know what you're gonna get with me. And this one is like washi tape overload. Since my edgy teen years, I haven't done kind of goth style. But yeah, I was just sort of experimenting. More experimenting. And this one is for Valentine's Day. I plan to give it to my husband. I don't know if he'll like it. But I already did the heart and washi tape. My next video, I really want to color her with all of you guys. So, enough of all of that boring stuff. This is what I plan to color with y'all today. And I did pick out some washi tape. Sometimes I like to pick out the washi tape first just so I know what kind of colors I'm going to deal with. Sometimes I just color it and then I find the washi tape that matches the most, so it's kind of to where it's just kind of a surprise for me and for you. But anyway, thanks for clicking on my video. I've never done a YouTube video before, let alone a drawing one, mostly because I'm not very good, but I saw other YouTubers do videos and they didn't start out perfect and they're always improving. So I thought, what better way to improve than do it with other people? And I call myself the unprofessional artist because everybody has techniques that they've learned. They've got all this planning and I mean, everybody's just wonderful at what they do, and they seem to have, like, a very professional manner about them. I don't. I just jump into it, and I hope my stuff looks good. So, it's great that you all want to watch me make a fool of myself. Because you know what? It's totally cool. I mean, I make a fool of myself every day. Like a true story about me, I've lived in Louisiana all my life. but I met someone, I got married, and I moved to Florida with him. And everyone asked me about my accent, and there's words I use that other people around here don't use. I worked at Target. And every time I see someone, you know, with too many items in their hand and they just need help, I'm just like, do you want me to grab you a buggy? And they're like, a what? Because in Louisiana we say buggy and everybody around here says cart. So I got to where I would make myself say cart. Like a lot of times I would fumble with my words because I'd have to remind myself that nobody says buggy around here. Everybody says cart. But anyway, yeah, that's one of the ways I make a fool of myself on a daily basis. I mean, there's others. But, I mean, do you really have to know? Like, of course you do. Like, I'll probably tell you too. But anyway, enough about me being a dippy. Another thing I thought about making videos, like my husband told me I should do it, I should just go for it. And like I realized very quickly, like I've been watching YouTubers on here do art and I love it. I mean, I love the way they're always informing people about how they do their techniques and stuff. And I realized nobody has an accent like mine. And I'm kind of worried because, I mean, what if y'all guys don't like it? And that's the reason why y'all don't want to watch me do videos. Because you don't like the way I talk. And so, I don't know. I have a little bit of anxiety over that. But, I mean, it's not a big deal. If you don't like it, then it's totally cool. And I'm not gonna, I totally get it. Like, there's some accents around here. I call it the Florida accent. And everybody's, like, got the same accent. For real. And, like, even my husband does. And it's so weird. But anyway, I'm gonna try to keep the southern drawl down to a minimum. I can't promise anything. But, you know, if it's your cup of tea, feel free to watch me, not creepily please, but you know, if you like it, welcome, thank you. So all I know is that my washi tape is navy blue. Like I said, I am not really professional in anything I do, and I know the people on YouTube, majority of them, they're not professional either, and you're probably thinking, well, you know, nobody's... No, there's no one right way to do art, and I'm very sorry. I've been, I'm not really set up. Like I said, this is my very first one, so I'm hoping that you all just stick with me here while I try to get all of this stuff together. Because you know what? I'm going to pause you real quick and I'm going to pick out all of my markers because this is probably annoying. Okay, I'm back. If you hear something, it's my washing machine because I was cleaning before I did this. I'm kind of in charge of all the cleaning right now. As always. Okay, so I got some stuff to work with. Like I said, this isn't planned. And I'm not trying to impress anybody that it's not planned. But yeah, it's not planned. I'm just trying to be spontaneous, fools. And I know there are a lot of gaps. Like, I'm sitting here talking, there are a lot of gaps. I'm very, 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 very sorry. But to be honest, I'm just kind of nervous about doing my first video because I don't know if people really like me. Okay, so my favorite markers are the Copics, like I'm sure everyone else's are. I've noticed that no one likes artist loft markers, and you know what? I don't either. Like, I have quite a few because back when I had no money, still don't have any money, but you know, back when I was desperate, I would buy one or two artist loft just to like give myself a better color selection. And I mean, if you're like me and it was like I was really, really broke, I mean, go for it if you want to complete your color collection. But like mine, they've kind of became mushy, as someone has said. And they're not very durable. Like, and I haven't even had mine for very long. They're just awful. When I say awful, I mean awful. Like, I'm cheap. For real cheap. But I would not buy them again. Even if I was desperate, I would save up my money. Sorry. I'm not very good with the camera thing. I bought one of these flexible tripods on Amazon. And it works okay. I'm just not very good with lighting and, you know, positioning it. Because like I said, this is my first video. I have no idea what I'm doing. I was told it'd be all okay. But then again, that person has to live with me that told me it'd be okay. So, you know, we can't really... Gotta take him with a grain of salt sometimes. Because he'll probably watch this and be like, oh, it's wonderful. And then everybody else is like, it kind of sucks, dude. Like, please stop. So, a part of my art background, actually 90% of my art background is practice. Just watching videos, seeing what everybody else is doing, kind of going with the flow on that. I wouldn't say it's the best way to learn because I feel like some classes or something would have really, really helped. But when you grow up in the middle of nowhere, beside like cow pastures and farm equipment and the nearest town, and I mean like the town where you go to Walmart is like 20 minutes away, it's kind of difficult to find art classes because everyone around there is corn, cotton, cows. Nobody's really interested in hosting art classes, which I had the idea of doing that. I wanted to go to the school board and ask them, you know, is there a classroom at the school that I could set up on the weekends? Kind of, but I mean, I didn't even pursue it. So, who knows if anybody would have showed up. I'm sure... I don't know. But, I mean, I'm not blowing smoke up my blah, blah, blah. But, you know, I was okay to be in that little small town. Like, I could teach little kids art. I don't know. But, yeah, now I live in Florida. And there's a ton of people and a lot of stuff to do. Like, I can't believe how many people live in one place. And I'm not exaggerating either. Like, when I got here, like, I'd been to Florida on vacation. I've been in the Panhandle. I don't live in the Panhandle right now. I'm just going to say I live close to Tampa. Very, very close to Tampa. And there's just people on the roads and people in the stores. And you're like, holy shit. Like, why do we have so many people living in one area? But I've been here for a year and a little over a year now. And I've kind of gotten used to it. So, fingers crossed. I'm still afraid I'm going to crash into people because they drive so crazy here. And I'm used to everybody going like 5 miles below the speed limit and having to stop in the middle of the road for tractors. Or like if a cow gets out, you gotta stop and call the person who owns the cow. If you don't know who owns the cow, then I'm very sorry, but you're not getting by. Like, you're gonna have to call around and say, who owns the cow on so-and-so street, if you have no idea. But anyway, yeah, I guess I should describe what I'm doing. I feel like everybody knows about Copics, though. I guess this is more like a draw with me sort of thing. I think I'm gonna title the video that. Draw with me, meet me. Your BFF, the unprofessional artist. I really hope the lighting is good. Like, I'm so worried that the lighting is bad. And I hope everybody can see it. The way I have my phone, it's just slightly above my head. And I'm very, very short. So it's kind of difficult for me to see what's going on with the camera. And like I said, this is my first time using the camera this way. I do have, like, I got very inspired, like, watching YouTubers do their art videos. And I did one of these already. And it was a full draw it, color it, washi tape it, talk about it. But the thing is, it was all one-handed because I was holding my phone recording it with the other hand. So that's why this is the first one, because that one just kind of, it really sucked. Like, I'm not even joking with you. It really freaking sucked. But I did it because for Christmas I got art supplies from my cousin. And she's really sweet. And I just wanted to do like a dedicated video of me coloring in her, in the sketchbook she got me. Because she was so excited to get it for me. And she draws too, by the way. I feel like if she were to put her video up right when I put this one up, which she doesn't make videos, but I feel like if she did and she put hers up and then I put mine up, no one would look at mine. They would all look at hers. Because she's way better than I am. But you know what? I've learned that we're not going to compare ourselves to everyone else, especially our family. Because that's whack, yo. No, really. I have a lot of issues with my own art. Mostly because I see everyone doing so well. But that's what YouTube helped me. Like, I saw people and their art's amazing. And if you're watching this, you probably know all the main YouTubers that do art. And, I mean, they're great. They really are. But if you look back at their later stuff, they're always evolving. I have a corgi, and she's mad at her brother. So if you hear her growling or barking, I'm not going to be attacked by a vicious wild animal. It's Eba. But anyway, I saw that the art's always evolving, and it looks nice. It looks nice now. It still looked nice back then, but they're always perfecting their art, and it just looks better and better as they go along. And I feel like it gets better and better because they have so many people to tell them, hey, you could try this, you could do this. Just a lot of constructive criticism. And that's what I want. I want someone... Drop the cap. I want people to tell me, hey, this is, you know, whatever, but you could improve it so much by doing this. Or hey, if you want to tell me this is ugly as sin, you should probably try to do this. If you have any constructive criticism at all, I don't mind. Like, I like it. That's when I had my first job here. And I had a manager, and she was trying to correct me on something, but she could tell that she had no idea how to correct me, and she was, like, nervous about it. And I'm like, hey, if I'm doing something that, that I can't do, or, you know, I have to do differently, just go ahead and tell me, because I'd rather be doing it right. Okay. Because I'd rather be doing it right than to be doing it wrong and, what is with this washi tape? You know what? Just go away. Then be doing it wrong and, you know, have somebody from, God forbid, corporate catch me in the act and be like, excuse me. So I like criticism. I like to improve. And I think everybody should. This is what I don't like about washi tapes. And I know everybody, I know I keep stopping in mid-sentence. I'm very sorry that I can't finish a freaking thought. But washi tape is so difficult sometimes because some of the patterns, like this one is sort of ombre. I don't know if you can see it on camera, but it goes from dark to light. So I'm having to flip it so I can have the lights with the dark. Actually, where's that stupid one? Here you go. You gotta size up the pattern with each other is another thing. I had no idea that I would choose blue for this. I thought this was gonna be a red one. I usually do blue with a lot of stuff. I'm gonna try not to do blue as much. But yeah, if you have any questions, comments, the questions being, why the hell did you do it like that? Why didn't you do it like this? Go for it. I'm ready. 'Cause I really do want to improve. I have no career, dreams with art. I mean, when I was younger, I was like, oh, yar, I'm gonna go work at Disney. But, yeah, I'm kind of over it. I just want to make pretty things. Isn't that what we all want to do, is make pretty things? The only sad thing is that I think it's gonna be pretty, and then it just doesn't. Okay, but about the washi tape. This is my X-Acto knife I got at Michael's. I get most of my stuff from Michael's. The washi tape I got in the dollar bin at Michael's. Well, it's 3 washi tapes for $1. So if you want some washi tapes for super cheap, Michael has like a whole bin. Most of them do. I've seen it at every single one of them. They've got a bin. But anyway, I'm just going to cut around this, get all this washi tape off of here, and then I'll be right back. Okay. I'm back. So, if you don't know about washi tape, sometimes it's super sticky, and it took me a little while because it was super sticky and it was trying to take off the paper with it. I hate when they do that. You know what I do when they do that, though? Let me get some. This is what I do when I have washi tape that's super too sticky to do anything with. You tear it off the length that you think you're gonna need. Scooch over. And you do this. Take some of the sticky off of it. And then you put it back on the paper. And you know what? It's not as sticky anymore. Pro tip. Except it's not. So, I got all of her top done. When I work with washi tape, I like to do borders. Don't ask me why. But I do. And it's cute. But that's why I like to do it, because it's cute. So. I don't know. You're just going to have to excuse me. This looks almost adequate. So the last thing we need to do is color her shoes. Where did my marker go? I had to put the thumb up. So let's just finish her shoes and we will wrap this video up, because I mean, if you're still with me, I know you're bored as heck. So I'm just doing it the same color as her hair. A lot of times I don't care about things like color schemes. Like, I know some artists use a limited amount of colors just to keep it all, whatchamacallit. But I like to use what I like to use. Because, I mean, think about it. Who perfectly matches their wardrobe? Like, in real life. Like, real life talk. Who matches their wardrobe perfectly? Like, who's gonna have matching shoes with their outfit? And I know, it's art. It's not supposed to be real life. But that's just how I think. Like, I forget where I heard this from. And I'm just using the white gel pen just to get the out of the lines, you know, cleaned up. Because, I mean, I'm an adult. And I gotta let people know that I stay in the lines. Just cleaning it up a little bit. But, you know, people say, well, you gotta use a color scheme. Make it look nice and artsy. Why? And also, when I do washi tape, sometimes I cut it a little too... I don't know if you could see that there. Focus. But it's like right there around the hair where I didn't quite make the cut. And I just find it a light color. And I fill it in a little bit. Most washi tapes I use, it's, oh, wonderful. Also, I'm using a phone to film this. Yeah, I have no camera. I have no microphone. This is just me being me. This is just me being a Rizal. I mean, I hope you're, like, making notes of all of this hip lingo. Because this is what the kids say back in my day. So, it's vintage. It's vintage lingo. My sister's 10 years younger than me, and I always ask her, what are the kids saying these days? And she always rolls her eyes. So, I'm pretty much done. It's simple. I didn't want to do a lot of blending and shading. Because when I use washi tape like this, I like to just do a simple piece. So, I'm going to sign it now so everybody knows that I did this. I don't know who else would take credit for this, but... Bloop. That's a me. But yeah, when I was doing the washi tape, I thought of a time back in grade school. And it was back when we didn't have assigned seats or anything, and everybody kind of switched desk every day, just sat where they wanted to sit. And as long as it didn't cause any problems, the teacher just let us, you know, whatever we wanted. But one time I drew something. It wasn't even that good. Like, this is back in grade school. But I drew something. And I left it in the desk overnight. And no. It wasn't overnight. It was, like, during recess. But I left it in there. I didn't sign it. And there was a boy who sat in my desk afterwards. And I forgot all about the drawing. And he finds the drawing. And he's like... Here, Miss Maxwell, I drew you a picture. And I'm sitting here thinking, that's mine. But I thought about that because I've never done a video of me actually drawing anything or coloring anything. And I've had, like, so many people in my life say, did you really draw that? And it always makes me think of that boy who took my drawing and he's, like, claiming it as his when everyone knew that he hadn't drawn a day in his life. But I didn't say anything because I was always super shy. I'm like, I'm not going to say anything about, you know, that's my drawing. But she accepted it and she put it on the wall behind her desk. I can't even remember what it was a drawing of. I just remember she really liked it. She's like, oh, thanks. Whatever your name is. I think his name was Travis or something. I'm like, how dare you? But anyway, now I can say to people, yes, I did draw this. Go look at my video because I am an artist on YouTube. A very unprofessional one. But anyway, thanks for watching. I will see y'all later.